Maybe it's just me. What's new, Pussycat? When my life is a little more stable, I intend to get a dog. It will be a small dog, perhaps a Jack Russell or one of those little wiener dogs, and I will name him Benjamin. I once heard about a breed of dog that is incapable of barking. That sounds quite promising. Perhaps Benjamin will be one of those. I want something adorable that doesn't invade my space, won't make unnecessary noise, and will love me without question. Basically the same qualities I want in a boyfriend. I'll be traveling a lot in the coming months, and then the lease is up on my apartment, and I'm moving, which might be limited by bringing an animal with me, so the timing's not right for a pet. A few days ago, when I opened my front door, a cat wandered into my living room, curled up on the rug, and began to purr. I was completely bewildered. She was more comfortable in my apartment than I am. I checked her tag. Her name, it informed me, was Frisky. I called the phone number below her name and left a message informing them of Frisky's whereabouts. Fearing for her safety, I allowed her to stay until the owner returned my call. I sat down to write. Moments later, Frisky joined me on my lap. This was a sweet kitty. Not that I wanted a kitty. But if I did want a kitty, I'd want one like this. I realized Frisky might be hungry, so I gave her tuna, which she ate with greedy enthusiasm. Then I realized with horror that she would need to relieve herself at some point, but I couldn't let her outside. What if I let her out and she ran away, and then the frantic owner called, only to discover I'd let their beloved feline slip from my grasp? I would have to buy a litter box. But what if my leaving for the store caused Frisky such distress that she peed all over my furniture? I called George.
You want me to go buy a litter box?
Yes, and some more tuna.
Fine.
And maybe some catnip and a toy on a stick to amuse her.
No.
George is not a cat person, but he conceded if he liked cats, he would like this one.
She is cute.
Frisky responded to this appraisal by rolling on her back and encouraging George to scratch her belly. She doesn't look like a Frisky, though.
You can't rename someone else's cat, Topher. It's tacky.
Despite this, George and I began calling the cat Linda. Linda slept on my bed that night, close to my head. I fell asleep to the sound of her purring. The next morning, I got the call.
Frisky's an indoor-outdoor cat. She likes to explore. Just let her out. She'll come home.
So I let her out. She had a home, and I didn't want a cat anyway. That night, walking about a block from my house, I saw a bouncing ball of white fluff crossing the street. It was Linda. She followed me all the way home, and I chastised her for it. Go away, Linda. You don't live here. Then I gave her some more tuna and entertained her with the feather on a stick I'd convinced George to go back and buy.
Topher, she's not yours.
But maybe she's not happy with her current owner. Maybe they don't appreciate her and she wants a new life.
Oh my God, you're a fucking homewrecker. If I ever get a boyfriend, I'm never leaving you alone with him.
George was, of course, correct. It was obvious from Linda's disposition and appearance that someone loved her very much. Someone completely oblivious to the risk that a crazy fag might kidnap her sweet kitty, rename it, and refuse to give it back. I picked Linda up and set her outside. She meowed at the door for a bit, confused by her abrupt departure, then gave up and took her leave. I watched her from the window.
You did the right thing, darling.
I miss her already.
I know, darling. There's nothing quite so bittersweet as the end of an affair.